Frontal light comes from the viewer's direction. Normally, shadows are formed under the nose, under the lower lip, and under the chin. So let's start by applying shadows in these areas using this reference as our guide. I'll select the skin layer. I will use the semi-hard round brush. You can use any brush that you like. To pick a shadow color, I will color pick the skin color again. Increase the saturation, decrease the brightness. I'll add the shadow here. And notice there is a shadow here, so I'll add this as well. There's some shadows under the ear here as well, so I'm gonna add that. And there's also some shadows around the edges of the cheek here. I'm gonna make it smoother by using smudge tool. Now I just refine the face a little bit, adding some very soft outlines just to define the shapes a little bit more. There are some very thin shadows underneath the top lip as well, so I'm gonna add that. Next, I will move on to the hair and add some shadows to it. I'll color pick the hair. For darker color, increase the saturation, decrease the brightness. Make sure your layer is pixel locked so you don't color on the parts that you don't want to. I'm just using the semi-hard round brush in very big size and just slowly defining the hair. Next, I'll add some highlights to the portrait. I will use the smudge tool again to soften some edges. After the highlight, I will continue to refine the face, adding some details here and there, following the reference. I will add a very strong highlight on the eyes, on the iris, using a very bright white color. Alright, right now, I think my portrait color looks too dull. I want to make it similar to the reference, so I'll go to the skin again. I like to use hue and saturation. And then I will hold alternate on the keyboard and click the line between the two layers to create a clipping mask, so that the adjustment layer only affects the layer underneath. Here, you see hue, saturation, and lightness. And you can modify them here. I'll increase the saturation. Instead of using the hue and saturation to adjust the brightness, I like to use curve. Let's click on it. And create a clipping mask. so that it only affects the layer underneath, which is the skin layer. Before and after. And now, I think I want to make the hair highlight stronger, like the reference. I will use a blending mode as well. To make color brighter, I like to use highlight mode. Paint lightly on the hair. On the shirt as well, just color pick any bright color. This is before, and this is after adding the lighting.